Hello friends, welcome to Maitri Mantras. My name is ANKUR Kumar Sharma and I am going to start today signals and systems. That is a very important subject in GATE as well as other some engineering students. They can prefer this. Signals and systems. So in signals and systems, this is the first lecture. In this first lecture, I will start with, okay, first of all, what is the signal? I will tell the meaning of this subject. So what is a signal and what is a system? Because this subject is completely based on two criteria, that is signals and systems. These are comprised with each other and then this subject is formulated. So now, what is the meaning of signals? Signal. So a signal is something that contains information that contains some information. Okay. So, in signal, what we have to understand, what is the meaning of a signal or what is the definition of a signal? So, a signal is something that contains some information, or we can write another definition that is also related to this. So, a signal is the mathematical representation. A signal is the mathematical representation. Of any physical phenomenon which contains some information. Okay, so friends, what is the definition for signal? A signal is something that contains some information. मतलब एक signal वो चीज है, या वो एक wave है, जिसके अंदर कोई ना कोई information छुपी हुई होती है. और अगर दूसरी definition हम देखें, so a signal is the mathematical representation of any physical phenomenon which contains some information. Means जो signal होता है, वो किसी फिजिकल फिनोमिनन का किसी फिजिकल फिनोमिनन का मैथमेटिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन होता है जिसके अंदर कुछ ना कुछ इंफॉर्मेशन छुपी होती है. सपोज लेट अस टेक सम एग्जांपल्स फॉर दिस. सो साइन टी कॉस टी टैन टी एक्सेट्रा. ओके एंड अनदर लाइक दिस इज आल्सो सिग्नल. दिस वन इज आल्सो सिग्नल. दिस वन इज आल्सो सिग्नल. And this one also signals. So all these are signals. Okay. So all these are examples of signals. Some of them can be a very well-defined function or well-defined signal, or some of them can be derived signals. Means we have to derive these signals with the help of some other standard signal. So this is the definition of a signal. So a signal is something that contains some information, or we can say a signal is the mathematical representation of any physical phenomenon which contains some information, and these are the examples for signals. Now friends, let us see what is a system. So in general we can see that something that takes one input and converts it into another output is called a signal. In general we can say like this. A signal is the physical arrangement, we can say physical arrangement, or we can also say it is the combination of various elements joined together. Or the accomplishment of any objective. Okay, so a signal is the combination of various elements joined together for the accomplishment of any objective. Okay. So this one definition, or we can also say a system is, sorry, a system, this is not a signal, this is a system. A system is the recombination of various elements joined together for the accomplishment of any objective. Or we can say a system is the combination of or recombination of various elements, the combination of various elements which takes one signal as input and converts it into an output. Okay friends, so we can also give the definition of a system, like a system is the combination of various elements which takes one signal as input and converts it into an output. Okay, so if we take one example, then we will give an input signal and this one is system, so it will be having system gain. So let us write system gain and then it will convert into output signal. Output signal. Okay, in this way we can convert this. We will apply input signal from here, then when it will pass from the system, or system gain will be multiplied with the input and we will get the system output. So in this way we can write the definition of a system. There can be various system, electrical system, mechanical system, various systems can be there. No need to remember these, only remember the standard definition, for this is not much use. So now let us take various operations on signals. So in this category, what are the various operations on signals? I am going to tell. So first operation is time shifting. Time shifting operation. So what is this time shifting operation is? I am going to tell here. Let us take one signal as the input. That input is XT. Let us take XT as input signal. Okay. So XT is taken as the input signal. Now yt, we have taken yt as the output. So if yt equal to x of t plus k, in case of time shifting, what will occur is yt, that is the output, will be the time shifted form of input because this one is shifted by k. So now there can be two cases. Shifting can be either in left side or it can be in right side, because we are having, suppose we are having one signal xt. Okay, first of all write the two cases. So case number one is if k is greater than 0, means if the value of k is positive. Okay, so if k is positive, then left shift will become left shift, or time advance shifting, left shifting or time advance shifting. Okay, so when the value of k is positive, so if k is 1, 2, 3, 4, like xt plus 1, xt plus 2, xt plus 3, so in this way it is appearing, and then here it will become left shift by k unit, by k unit, means if k is 1, then it will be left shift by 1 unit, if k is 2, then it will become left shift by 2 unit, and if it is k is having 3, then it will become left shift by 3 unit. So in this way we can do this. Next is case number 2. Here if k is negative, so if k is less than 0 means k is negative value, then it will become right shift or time advance shift, time delayed shifting. Okay, so this is the second case. So if k is less than 0 means the value of k is negative, so then it will become right shifting or time delayed shifting by k units, by k units. So this is the second case. In case of time shifting, what will happen is if k is positive, then it will become the left shift, or we can say the time delayed, time advance shifting, or if k is negative or k is less than 0, then it will become right shift or time delayed shifting by k unit. Now friends, let us take one example to understand this. I think you have remembered this and also note down. So if you consider one example, suppose this one is x of t sun is xt comma t. Okay, this signal is xt comma t. Now what we have to find out, y of t plus 1. So we can remember this. So the x of t plus 1, we have to calculate the value of x of t plus 1. So we can remember that this is the case of xt plus k. But what is the value of k? So xt plus k, it is having k equal to 1. So we can remember if k is positive, then what is the case? It is the case of left shift or time delay, time advance shifting by k unit or 1 unit. So it will become xt plus 1. It will become left shift by 1 unit. So if we shift 0, then it will become minus 1, and 2 will become 0, sorry, 2 will become 1. So in this way, these units will shift towards left by 1 unit. The value of 0 will become minus 1. This 1 is, this is 1, so this 1 will become 0, and this 2 minus 1 will become minus, sorry, 2 minus 1 is 1. It will become 1. So xt plus 1 comma t, so this is the case of right shift or left shift. Okay, left shift. So we can also say this left shift or time advance shifting. Left shift by 1 unit or time advance shifting by 1 unit. So we can also write here time advance shifting. Time advance shifting by 1 unit. Now we can also take one more example. So let us take the same example, but we have to calculate the value of x of t minus 1 equal to what. So if we have calculated the value of xt minus 1, so we can remember xt plus k, and here k is equal to minus 1. So it will become x of t minus 1. So this is k is negative, and we have studied that if k is negative, then it will become right shifting by k unit, and here k is 1, so it will become right shifting by 1 unit. So we will shift this signal xt by 1 unit. So it will become, suppose this is x of t comma t, so it is 0 to 2 and the value is 1. So now it will become x of t minus 1. So it will be shifted towards right. So it will become 1 to 3. 1 to 3. This is t. This is x of t minus 1. And the value is 1 only. Okay, friends. So in this case, what we have done? We have just shifted the value of this signal, all the values of this signal, towards right by 1 unit. Because the value at 0 has gone at the value of 1. And the value of 2 has gone at the value of 3. So this is the case of right shift or time delayed shifting. Right shift or time delayed shifting. Time delayed shifting. Right shift or time delayed shifting. So this one is the case for right shift or time delayed shifting. So what we can remember here in the case of time shifting, this point you have to remember, just note down this also. In case of time shift, we can remember that not in case of time shifting, time shifting signals, time duration does not change. Time duration does not change. Okay, so just remember this, that in case of time shifting, the time duration of the signal does not change. It will be same only. You can see in the previous cases that we have taken two examples, and there we have just shifted the signal in time domain, that in case of k greater than 0, we have shifted it towards left by k unit, and in case of left right shifting or xt minus 1, we have shifted the signal in right side by 1 unit. So there is no need of any other cases. So in this, you have to remember this, that time duration of the signal does not change in case of time shifting case. So friends, we will see the next case in next lecture. Thank you. And all share, subscribe to kar lijiye thoda sa na, kyunki usse fayda hoga aapko bhi aur hame bhi thoda sa motivation milta hai. Thank you.